Assalamu alaikum everyone. Today from practice set 3.5 we are taking question number 9. In this question number 9 you will see the question is, by using factor theorem in the following examples, determine whether q of x is a factor of p of x or not. It means what? In the question, see here, p of x means polynomial in term of x is given. Polynomial in term of x is given. It is x cube minus x square minus x minus 1. Okay. It is the polynomial in term of x. And here against that polynomial, one more polynomial is given. But it is said that q of x. So q of x means it is the value for that variable x. And that is x minus 1. So here we have to determine whether this value x minus 1 or this second polynomial x minus 1 is a factor of that first polynomial or not. And we have studied in that last lecture that how to determine the factor of any polynomial. It means what? After replacing the value of this x by here plus 1, if you are getting 0 as a remainder, then you can say this second polynomial is a factor of the first polynomial. Okay. So see how to solve it. First you write solution. First write p of x. P of x is equal to x cube minus x square minus x minus 1. It is p of x. Now we will put here x minus 1 is the second polynomial, but here we are taking the value of x is opposite number of minus 1, which is plus 1. So write p of plus 1 is equal to wherever x are there in that place. Now we are substituting positive 1. So 1 cube minus 1 square minus 1 minus 1. Now write therefore p of 1 is equal to cube of 1 is 1 minus square of 1 is also 1. Afterward, here minus 1 minus 1. So write therefore p of 1 is equal to, see here, 1 minus 1, 0. 0 minus 1 is minus 1 and minus 1 minus 1 is minus 2. Or like this also you can do. See here, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 3. From this 3 negative 1, we got here minus 3, and minus 3 and plus 1 is minus 2. Okay. So what is the remainder here, tell me? Remainder is the value of that polynomial after replacing the value of x by 1. So remainder is minus 2. Here say remainder is minus 2. Minus 2, which is not the 0. Here remainder, it should be 0. Because here the factor of the polynomial means what? After substituting the value of that second polynomial in the first polynomial, we should get here remainder 0. But here the remainder is not the 0. And that's why we can say second polynomial means q of x is not the factor of p of x. So write therefore q of x is not the factor of p of x. Understood? So what you will do? You will substitute the value of this second polynomial, but in the opposite sign, in this first polynomial. And if you are getting here 0, then you can say second polynomial is the factor of first. If the remainder is not 0, then you can say q of x is not the factor of the p of x. Question number 2 is p of x is equal to 2x cube minus x square minus 45. For this first polynomial, the second polynomial is q of x is equal to x minus 3. Here we have to determine whether x minus 3, which is the second polynomial, is the factor of the first polynomial px or not. Okay, so first we are writing this first polynomial in the term of x. So write p of x is equal to 2x cube minus x square minus 45. Now we will replace this x by opposite value or opposite number of this minus 3, which is plus 3. So write therefore p of plus 3 is equal to 2, then in the bracket 3 cube minus 3 square minus 45. Got it? Write therefore p of 3 is equal to, here cube of 3 is 27 and 27 2's are 54, correct? Now minus square of 3 is 9 minus 45. Further write, therefore p of 3 is equal to 54. Now here minus 9 and minus 45 will add because of similar sign. Which similar sign is there? Minus sign for both of this. So here answer will come in minus 45 plus 9. Add this 54, correct? Now say therefore p of 3 is equal to 54 minus 54, 0. So what is the remainder here? After dividing first polynomial by second, the remainder is 0. So here say remainder is 0. Remainder is 0. So what will you conclude? Say therefore q of x is the factor of p of x, means second polynomial is the factor of the first polynomial. Understood? Likewise, we have to determine whether second polynomial is the factor of the first polynomial or not. Okay, very easy. Only by replacing the variable by opposite number of that factor, if you are getting remainder 0, then that second polynomial is the factor of first. If the remainder is not 0, then you can say here the second polynomial is not the factor of the first polynomial. If you are having any doubts, any queries, you can ask me or you can text in the comment box. Okay?